it! Stop it! I'm coming for you!
Well, tighten that tail. Okay, let's go.
That looks like a seriously bad choice, Mr. Stafford. All the best with that.
I'm just trying to get out of this gorge.
This feels sketchy.
Man has always battled nature in a bid to conquer it. I'm explorer Ed Stafford.
I need to be so careful up here.
And I've put myself through extreme tests of endurance and isolation to become a survival expert. Now, I want to push myself even further to find out what I'm really made of.
All right, come on, Stafford, keep going.
So I'm testing my skills against the world's toughest survivalist.
If I was going to gamble, I'd put the money on myself.
Here's hoping I'm the first woman out. This is my race.
A head-to-head race.
Go!
Across the wild, unforgiving landscapes of China.
Zin! Yeah!
To find out if I'm on top of my game. It's not about beating my chest.
This is properly hard.
It's about taking my skill set to the next level. This time, I'm taking on my old friend and teacher, Will Lord.
I've got this challenge!
He's a primitive skills expert and the man who taught me a lot of what I know about prehistoric survival. We're heading deep into the bamboo forests, hostile caves, and rocky mazes of central China.
Ed's going to miss things because he's going to be moving so fast. I'll be listening to the birds. I'll be actually listening to the forest itself. Yes!
I'm in China, and I'm up against probably the toughest opponent that I've faced so far.
Ed!
Will!
Hello, mate.
Hello, mate.
How you doing?
Wow, how lovely to see you.
And you. And you.
Oh.
Mate, I'm just stoked you're here. I haven't seen you in ages.
I know, it's been, what, 7 years?
Yeah.
Will Lord is the leading primitive skills expert in the UK. 7 years ago, I employed Will to teach me basic survival skills. He taught me how to make a bow and arrow. He taught me how to nap stone into a cutting tool. Our relationship in the past has been very much one of teacher of students.
This course here, I've designed it to push the fellas to the extreme limit. They will start deep in a treacherous gorge that runs east to west, and they will find their way south towards a disorienting maze of limestone shards called the Dragon's Teeth. They will then enter one of the largest bamboo forests in Asia. On the other side lies a massive sinkhole. The first man to reach the bottom will be the winner.
I've been over this journey with a GPS, and this is a maze. This area, you've got sheer cliffs, massive cave systems that will draw you in for shelter, but you have to be very, very careful. To me, the biggest issues here, as we can see, is the weather. It could be 35 degrees, it could be 10 degrees at night.
So, Ed, I want to up the stakes a little bit. I'd like you to leave your knife back here.
So, with no knife?
Well, there's plenty of rocks down there, and you came to me for a lesson, innit?
Yeah, okay, mate.
Yeah?
Yeah, all right.
Challenge is on!
Yeah! Cold.
It's super slippy. The water's moving really fast.
It's getting a bit tricky around here.
Every rock is covered in moss, slippy as an ice rink. So if I can find some way to branch to the left, then I'll be going back south. I'm just wondering whether I can get up that gully up there. It's a gamble, but I'm going to take the risk.
That looks like a seriously bad choice, Mr. Stafford. All the best with that. That's just completely insane.
The rocks are slippy on either side, but potentially, if I can get out, this does not look very good, actually, though. This feels sketchy.
On the tracker, it's quite interesting to see the tactics that Ed and Will are using. Ed is taking the more direct but harder route south. He will need to cross dangerous 300-foot limestone cliffs while Will is heading west, following the river. This is a longer but less risky route out of the gorge.
The shell of the bamboo has got silica in it, and you can actually strike a spark off of it. So what I have here is the saw, and then what I have here is the half board. Rub that backwards and forwards quite hard.
Baby, we have fire.
What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to use the resin as a glue now. I need cordage. I need to bind the handle onto that knife. Nettle makes really great cordage. Just by itself, it doesn't really have what I'm looking for. So we need to spin it. That locks it all together. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to bind them up tight. Good, I'm happy with the knife. You made a stone tool today, Ed? I get a suspicion not.
Humidity, it's 80% humidity here, and getting a little pile of dust to reach the right temperature to ignite is that much harder. Come on. I think I've got it. I've got it! Happy days.
There might be a lunch going on in here. Things like widgery grubs are living in here. They're a great source of protein. Oh, look at that juicy little fella. There's got to be some protein in there, right? Every little bit helps, don't you think? It was a little bit like eating juicy bark.
And I'm getting colder by the second. I can feel breeze again. I can feel breeze coming. There could indeed be an exit, not very far ahead. I've had no option but to enter the water now. And it's getting much fiercer now. Oh, that's cold. That is properly cold. No, that's too cold. I'm too deep. That water is likely to be about 8-9 degrees Celsius, and I do risk going down with hypothermia. I've decided to stop, and I'm going to use the firewood.
It's the end of day two. Ed still hasn't reappeared on the tracker, so I can only presume he's in a cave somewhere. I'm getting slightly concerned because if nothing happens on this in the next few hours, then I'm going to have to go and look for him. These guys have been on the move for 3 days. They are probably burning around 3,500 calories a day because of the amount of running and climbing they had to do. If they haven't eaten yet, they're going to be starving.
I'm just thinking, if I can get some ash leaves, then what I can do is crunch up the ash leaves, get the saponins out of them that will then starve the fish of oxygen, and fingers crossed the fish that are in there, that are hiding in the little crevices, will just float to the surface, and I've got supper. There's one. Yes, because it's so small there's no need to gut it at all. This is what I needed. Doesn't taste like sushi. It's a bite-sized protein snack. Ah. Oh. Ah. Oh. That was... Maybe I should have gutted it. That was the most disgusting thing that's made me happy ever.
Hold on, I think I've seen something. Got him. Look at the size of this. I got adrenaline pumping through my body. I just feel like I've been at war. There's no joy in taking that. That's the natural order.
This is the largest natural bamboo forest in Asia. And it just goes for miles and miles and miles. It's impenetrable. They haven't got compasses, they haven't got maps. And you can get disorientated really quickly.
Right, all I need to do now is to lash on crossbars like a ladder, climb to the top, and I've got my view. This platform is a little risky, but if I can get up there and see the route, it'll be a massive advantage.
This is the moment of truth.
Oh, yes! That is extraordinary. I've got a view over the entire bamboo canopy. A monkey's eye view.
Yes, the pasture!
This last bit is so, so critical. And you have to think about it. They're tired, they're racing, they've got adrenaline, they're dehydrated, and they've got a lack of food.
My legs feel like lead weights. My lungs are burning. I just hope I haven't pushed too hard too soon.
Ed Stafford! I'm coming for you!
And I can see Gary. There he is. How you doing?
I'm all right, and you?
Did I win?
Come on!